Today, we have a special treat for you, because we're going to the zoo. Oh, not a zoo with bars and cages. That would be way too outrageous. We'll get the orchestra to play to bring the animals your way. Woodwinds, percussions, bass, and strings can reproduce most living things with bow and reed and horn and stick. But before I lay it on too thick, let's begin the big charade and start the animals' parade. So full of pride, he makes all others step aside. To hear the lion in his jungle, listen to the piano rumble. And when you hear the lion roar, you roar right back, right from the floor. Goes cock-a-doodle-doo. The chicks and hens go crazy too. Just listen to the strings go swoop like cackling chickens in their coop. Feathers furiously beat the air. They flap and flap, but go nowhere. A donkey opera you'll never hear, but that should make you stand and cheer. With just two notes, a he and ha, the sound would rub your eardrums raw. But fast they are, we're here to tell, as pianists show quite well. The tortoise plods along so slow. Nothing seems to make him go. He really is the slowest poke. The can-can music is a joke. Watching this big fellow creep, the double basses go to sleep. The elephant with tusk and trunk takes every step with a big kerthunk. He shakes the moon, he shakes the stars, he even shakes the planet Mars. To hear him as he takes his stroll, listen to the bass viol. In fact, they hardly touch the ground. Boing, 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 ouch! Something sharp was in her pouch. Showing how this lady springs might break a few piano strings. A sparkling, shimmering tank of light, colors that are wild and bright. A swish of tail, a flip of fin, that's the world the fish swim in. But to continue this discussion, we need a bit of light percussion. are stubborn fools. Often we compare to mules. We can push and we can shove, but only a fire makes them move. And to reproduce their voice, a scratchy fiddle is our choice. These birds never smell the flowers. All they do is count the hours. The clarinet, so low, so high, is wasted on this two-note guy. If you were shut in and never flew, I'm sure that you'd be cuckoo, too. So twittery and cute, are nicely captured by the flute. They sing and soar, the winds may blow, and make a mess on those below. Of all the animals I've heard, I think I'd soonest be a bird. Pianists as monkeys? Please! Pianists don't live in trees. Sure, they sometimes jump and swing, but that could mean most anything. Although the reeds and strings won't tell us, I think they are simply jealous. mastodons are known now only by their bones. It's hard to think that long ago they really put on quite a show. Now, to make these fossils real takes xylophone and glockenspiel. Majestically, she glides along, no matter what else is going on. The universe might just go poof, but the swan remains serene, aloof. Anyone that stays that mellow should be represented by the cello. Now we've come to the end of the show, when all of the animals take their bow. Birds and fish and monkeys too all play with each other in our zoo and show, though differences abound, together they make a lovely sound. So listen as the players play and the conductor beats away and think to yourself, this is really fun. This music is for everyone. Then tell your parents, make them see you want to come back to the symphony. Thank you. What an excellent audience you were. So, I think we have a few more minutes here, and we wanted to open it up a little bit and see if there were any questions from you guys for any of the members of the Chamber Orchestra, or myself, or anyone else. Yes, young man. Yeah. You brought your turtle in today. Awesome, awesome. So when the tortoise was playing, did that remind you of your turtle at all? Okay, great, great. Yes, young lady. Okay, what are all your names? We're gonna do this real quick. So,
Thomas.
Pam.
Tim.
That's Mike.
Jacob.
Elisa. Allison.
Jay.
Bob.
Zach.
Sue.
Great, there you go. That's all their names. I'm Max. All right, we'll go over here. Let's see, young lady. How long have you guys been practicing? Well, I've been acting since I was a freshman in high school. Thomas, how long have you been practicing?
That could be two questions. I started on piano when I was about 3 years old. So I'm an old man, so I've been doing this for a while. But how long have we been practicing? This group, the Chamber Orchestra of the Springs, has existed for about 33 years. And the musicians, they change in and out. Conductors even change in and out. But we actually only, we all know this piece really well. It's a very important piece. So we've all played it before, we've all done it before. So to put this together for you this morning, we just had one rehearsal last night, and that was it.
All right, we'll do this one other way, because I think this is a pretty interesting question. Musicians, raise your hand if you've only been playing your instrument for 5 years. 10 years. 15 years. 20 years. 20 years. 25 years. 30 years. 40 years. 50 years. 60 years. Hey, we've got a winner there. So, hey. So, to be really good at an instrument the way all of these folks are, you have to play it for a long time. Let's see, we had another, yes, young man in the glasses, sure.
Can you do Harry Potter?
Can you do Harry Potter? Do you guys take requests? Yes, no? Maybe sometime. They'll put that in their hat for next time. Yes. Do you like Tootsie Rolls? Let's take a poll. Who likes Tootsie Rolls? Raise your hand. Yeah, we like Tootsie Rolls. Great. We're gonna come over here. Young man. Yeah. What are the instruments? Well, we've got cello and double bass and piano and viola and violin and flute and piccolo and clarinet. And the glockenspiel and xylophone are the percussion instruments in the back. Those are the instruments in the chamber orchestra today. Yeah. Yeah. The flute and the piccolo? Yeah, sure. Thank you, thank you. Yeah, you're taking the glasses there. I play an instrument? I play a little bit of guitar. Mostly I sing, so my voice is my instrument. Yeah, right there. How many violins are there? There are two violins, but it's a little bit of a trick question because the viola kind of looks like a violin, but that's not a violin, it's a viola. This is a great request. Anybody who plays the violin among you guys, stand up. All right, have a seat. And now anyone who plays viola, stand up. Who are viola players? And have a seat. And how many cellos do we have? Cellists in the house. All right. Do we have any double bass players here at school? That's a big instrument for a little body. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to swing around to... Okay, here, right here. Why not? Well, the Colorado Springs Chamber Orchestra is the company. So, yes, is the answer to that question. And we're going to come around here to this. Yes?
Have you played at any other schools?
Have you played at any other schools? Oh, I'm going to have to go back to Thomas for this one because I don't know the answer.
Yes, we have. More than I can count over the years. Quite a few. Right. But I've never had more fun than I've had this morning.
There you go. We're going to go for the back. You can't leave out the people in the back. Yeah. Let's have hands down. Yeah, right here.
Can you sing a song for us?
Oh, you're going to put me on the spot. Let me think about it, and if you're lucky, I'll sing a song. Oh, very good, very good. Good comment. Here, let's take a question.
What are their favorite instruments and the favorite animal that they played today?
Interesting. Okay, well, we'll take a brief sampling. So, is it safe to assume that your favorite instruments are the ones that you play? Yeah? Any of you guys wish you were like an electric guitarist instead? Yeah? Say that.
Play the cello.
Okay, our flute player wants to play the cello. Yeah. Let's see, and the other question was, oh, favorite animals. Let's see, what's your favorite animal, Pam?
I love the swan. I'm just not very partial.
You're biased, that's okay. What about you, Thomas?
The panda.
Oh, I know what that one sounds like. And here, let's go ask our pianists what they play a lot on this piece. So what are you guys' favorite animals?
Cats.
He likes cats. Kitties, we got a couple of kitty-loving piano players. Great, pianists. Excellent, excellent. Let's see. What's my clock at? How much time we got left? 3 minutes. All right, we're gonna take a few more questions here. Pardon me, I'm gonna sneak through here. We gotta go to the back here. Okay. Let's see, Hugh. Oh, are there other players in the chamber orchestra who aren't represented today?
Yes, quite a few.
Quite a few.
About 35.
Wow, so crowded. That would be really crowded up on that small stage, wouldn't it? Yeah, that'd be hard. Great. And here. How many cellists all together in the chamber orchestra? Four or five cellists. We're wondering how many violas there are all told. Usually six. Okay, great. Young man in the middle, you're going to have to speak louder.
Okay,
yeah.
So, okay, great.
Ah, interesting. I'm going to bring that back up to Mr. Thomas Wilson here to respond to. The question is does the chamber orchestra have a band section?
We have what could pass as a band section. We have our winds and brass. And today we only have two woodwinds and there's no brass at all. But usually we have two flutes, two oboes, two clarinets, two bassoons, two horns, two trumpets, and one percussion. So, hey, who are the trumpet players?
Yeah!
Yeah! All right. We're running out of time. I wanted to say thank you from the Chamber Orchestra of the Springs. Have a great morning. Thank you. You've been great. Thank you.